What is up, you guys? I am Missy Renee, and in today's video, we're going to talk about what to do if you're not seeing any movement in the 3D, or what to do if you're not seeing progress being made, or if you're not seeing anything unfolding. So, if manifestation and conscious creation are topics that you are interested in learning more about, then definitely do not forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that way you're notified when I release new videos every week. If you're interested in more resources such as one-on-one coaching or my brand new membership group, I will have that linked down in the description box below. So definitely be sure to check it out. And I decided to make this video because it is naturally a question that I get asked all the time, every day, multiple times a day. Missy, I'm not seeing any movement. I'm not seeing anything unfolding in the 3D. What should I do? And naturally, this is one of the things that, especially when we're new, we're going to be struggling with probably the most, is the lack of movement or not being able to see anything happen in your 3D. This, in fact, causes a lot of stress, a lot of uncertainty, and a lot of doubt. As humans, the way that we have all been raised and how we've lived our entire lives is by the reacting to the 3D. We've always taken cue from what's going on around us in our physical environment to help us gauge what is going on. And when we learn about manifesting, it becomes the exact opposite. So once again, this is one of the many things that we are trying to learn to undo. And one of the many things that we are trying to get out of the habit of doing, which is not always easy said than done. When we are not able to see what is happening around us, or if we've been doing this for a while and we have yet to see any movement in the 3D or any sign that things are going in the right direction for us, naturally, we're going to get confused and we're going to freak out. So if this sounds familiar, if this sounds like something that you're going through, if you want to learn what to do if you're not seeing movement in your 3D, then definitely stick around to the end of the video because we're going to talk all about movement, what you really need to be looking out for, and I'm going to walk you through exactly what to do if you find that this is the case for you so that you can ultimately get out of this struggle and finally manifest whatever it is that you want. So diving right in, there are two main reasons or two things to know as to why you're not seeing movement in your 3D. And the first, and arguably the most common reason, is because, quite frankly, you don't actually believe that what you've imagined is now yours. One of the first things that we learn when learning to manifest is that we need to imagine ourselves living as the version of us that we desire to be, or living in that reality in imagination that we desire to experience. We learn that by doing this, we are moved into a state or a reality where what we desire already exists. So we learn that through imagination, we can move into a state where our desire already exists, and we can finally experience it in our 3D reality. And this is where techniques come in. We do certain techniques to better help us getting into that state of the wish fulfilled. We use techniques like imagining in the state akin to sleep, or affirming, or scripting, or what have you. We use these techniques to help us feel what it would feel like if we were now living the reality that we desire to live. But if you've been doing a technique for some time, weeks, perhaps even months, and you're failing to see any movement, the first thing that we want to do is start reacting and wondering why we're not seeing any movement, wondering why it's not happening. And this is in part because of some of the misconceptions that we have around techniques. a lot of us look at techniques like there's something that we have to do in order to manifest whatever it is that we want. That the techniques are some kind of prerequisite to manifesting what it is we're trying to get. When this is not the case, we use techniques to help us feel the feelings of what it would be like if we had the thing that we want. We use techniques to help us get familiar with what it would feel like if what we desired is already ours. This helps us move into our desired state and helps make it so it becomes the dominant state that we dwell in. So we're not using the techniques to try to get anything. We use the techniques to enjoy being that person, to enjoy being in that state. There is a big difference between these two. So make sure that you are using the techniques and that you are imagining correctly. So for this first reason, it really does boil down to a lack of faith in what we are trying to do and what we're trying to manifest. I have people tell me all the time that they have 100% faith in the law. But if that were really the case, then there would not be a reaction to what is happening in the 3D, or lack of happening in the 3D. If you truly did believe that your imagination creates reality and you had complete faith in this, then you would not be anxious about the 3D movement, because you would know that what you imagine precedes what happens to you in the 3D. And this is what it means to live in the end. When you are stressed about lack of movement in the 3D, it ultimately points to that deep down, you're not convinced that what you've desired is already yours. Now, I think it would also help to clarify what this means by living in the end, because there too is some misconception and confusion around what that means. And a lot of people are going about it in a very convoluted and ineffective way. A lot of people think that living in the end means that you have to pretend that what you desire is right now your 3D reality, that it's happening in the 3D right now. Naturally, this is going to feel a bit delusional and silly, because you can clearly see and tell with your physical senses that this is not the case. But this is not what it means to live in the end. Living in the end means that you know that it is going to happen. You know that because you have imagined, then it must unfold and you will experience it in the 3D down the line. Not that it is happening physically right now. Living in the end just means that it's a done deal. That even though you are not yet able to experience it in the 3D right now, that it is coming and that you know it will come to pass. And this is one of the most common reasons that people have their doubts and that they struggle. A lot of people are under the false premise that they have to believe that what they've imagined is now happening in the 3D right now. Instead of believing that because you have imagined it, it will come. Now, there's a metaphor that I like to use and talk about with my clients to kind of give you a better picture of what it is actually like to live in the 3D. Let's say, for example, that you are getting ready to go on vacation and that you're planning a vacation. You book your flights, you book your hotel, you get all the planning sorted, and then all you need to do at that point is to just sit back and get excited, because you know that you're going to go on vacation. You've already booked the flights, you've already arranged everything that needs to be done. So in that interim, you're just waiting for it to come. You're just waiting to go on vacation. But you don't sit there and try to pretend like you're on vacation right now. You don't try to sit there and doubt that you're going to go. You know you're going to go. you know that it's a done deal. You know that you've already made all the plans and arrangements and that it's coming. So you sit back and you relax and you just get excited for what is about to come. Living in the end is no different. Living in the end means that because we have imagined and because we have felt our desire in imagination, and that we have felt that reality and we have given it as many tones of reality that we can muster, that it must unfold. We know that it's a done deal. We've already booked the ticket and now we're just waiting to take the ride. The second reason that you may not be seeing any movement is because there might not be any physical movement that you will notice. But just because you can't see what's going on behind the scenes does not mean that nothing is unfolding. It is through our subconscious that everything is rearranged to get us from where we are now to where we desire to be. It is the job of the subconscious to know the how and when something is going to come about for us. It is not our job to consciously know how this is going to unfold, and that is okay. But this is yet again where we stumble, because as humans, we feel like we need to know, we need to see signs, we need to have some kind of proof or some kind of signal that we are in fact on the right path. But there may not be any signs that you can point to consciously that things are in fact moving. Because signs follow, they do not precede, which means that once again, your imagination precedes what happens in the physical reality. So you cannot see any signs of your manifestation before it has come to pass in the physical. Because of this, we must instead turn to how we are feeling internally, and we must use that as the gauge or indicator as to whether or not we are moving in the right direction, because there will be a shift internally before we start seeing things materialize on the outside. So let's say, for example, that you're trying to manifest a specific person. You may not be able to see or know what your SP is thinking about. You may not be able to see or know that they are having a change of heart about you and that they are contemplating reaching out to you. These are things that you obviously are not going to be able to pick up on in the 3D, but that does not mean that this is not happening or that this is not the case. Again, it is the job of the subconscious mind to take you from where you are now to where you desire to be. Neville called this the bridge of incidence, in which you will be naturally drawn from where you are now to your desired end, and that there is no conscious planning that you need to do. There is no figuring out how it's going to happen. You just need to let it unfold naturally, because the subconscious knows ways in which we do not. And the way that our manifestation unfolds almost always comes in a way that we could never consciously conceive. So if you are doing everything right, if you are persisting in living in the wish fulfilled and living in the end, but you're still not seeing any movement, that does not necessarily mean that there is no movement. Just because you can't see it does not mean it is not playing out in the most perfect and natural way that it could. And for those who are on the bridge of incidence or just about to cross the bridge of incidence, you will not be consciously aware that this is happening until after the fact. You may, in hindsight, be able to look back and see that that was a bridge of incidence and how it unfolded, but rarely ever are we going to know right there in that moment. So again, trust the process and keep persisting, because we do not always know. And just because we are not seeing any 3D movement does not mean things are not happening. So what should you do if you are not seeing any 3D movement? What are some things that you can do to help alleviate any stress or anxiety or doubt because you feel like things are not moving or that things are stagnant? First and foremost, you need to ask yourself, do I really believe that what I desire is already mine? Do I really believe that what I've imagined is in fact going to come to pass? Do I really believe that SP and I are going to wind up together? Do I really believe that I will be abundant or have that successful business? Do I really believe that my imagination creates reality? And again, this doesn't mean that you have to believe that it's happening in your physical 3D reality right now, because clearly you can see that that's not the case. This just means that you believe that it is going to happen. And if the answer is no, or the answer is sometimes I do and sometimes I don't, that's okay. That is totally okay. But that being the case, I would strongly suggest that you incorporate some faith building exercises in your day to day. The best way, the fastest way to build our faith and trust in the law is by testing it often. And this is what Neville always stressed to do. And this is what I'm going to stress to do, because you should never take my word for this. You should never take anybody's word for this. You should be testing the law always. Test it with everything, big things, small things, and everything in between. Create a list of some things that you want to see appear and some things that you would like to see manifest. Or try the ladder experiment. There are many different ways that you can go about doing this. There are many different ways that you can go about testing and playing around with the law. And try it on some things that you don't have any emotional attachment to first, because the more that you prove it to yourself by seeing it, by physically noting that you are in fact creating all of these things, the doubt is going to naturally subside. And you will naturally begin to build more and more trust in the law. And you want to keep building the faith until it is unshakable, until you know that no matter what the 3D tells you, what you've imagined is going to come to pass. And that is the key indicator. That is how you know that you are in fact living in the end. When you are really, truly living in the end, you are not distracted or disturbed or thrown off by whatever happens in your 3D. And I'll give you guys a personal example of something that happened to me when I was trying to manifest my SP back. I remember once that I was, I think, browsing through Instagram or Facebook or something. I was on social media and a picture came up of my friend, a mutual friend of mine in SP, and they were all having dinner, and SP was sitting next to a very attractive woman. And before I had really built my faith in the law, before I knew about manifesting, my reaction would have been to go through the freaking roof. I would have lost it. But because of my faith, because I trusted the process, because I knew that the law is constant and it works for everything, and that we are always creating through the power of our imagination, it didn't even faze me. Didn't even care. You could have showed me a picture of him making out with another woman and I would have been like, nope, not what I imagined, not what's gonna happen. Sure enough, 2 weeks later, he came back. So this is really the point that I'm trying to drive home, is that there are really two ways to tell why things may not be showing up or why you might not see any movement in your 3D. And it either comes from lack of faith, which is the most common, or because you may not be able to physically see it before you are on the bridge of incidence, until you are naturally on the other side of your bridge and you are in your new dominant state, when that new desired state becomes the dominant state. And once you have arrived here, that is when things are going to start unfolding for you. But if you're still not able to stop fixating on the 3D, if you still find yourself very anxious, then I would be testing, testing, testing with everything. Building the trust in the law is a key, crucial component of manifestation. Not that you have to believe that it's physically here right now. It's not trying to pretend or convince yourself that something is physically present when it's not. This is not trying to act as if it's already here when you can clearly see that it's not. This is about knowing that once you have imagined it, and once you are able to persist in that state, that it must come, that it is going to happen. You must be unshakable in that fact. No matter what appears in the 3D, whatever movement shows up, good, bad, indifferent, or lack of movement, you know that it's coming. And the more that we persist in that state, and the more that we're able to build our faith, and the more familiar that we get with the feeling of what it would feel like if we were now living as the person that we desire to be, or that we now had the thing that we desire to have, the more and more that you're able to do this, and the stronger and stronger that your faith grows, and the more that this becomes your unshakable foundation, that is when your success is inevitable. And that is when you can manifest anything that you want. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, do not forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in checking out any of my other resources, I will have the links down below to one-on-one coaching, my blog, my social channels, my membership group, and my new podcast. So do not forget to check them out. Also, do not forget to check out these videos over here. Each video is a different topic, but it all goes into how to manifest the very best life possible. So until we meet next time, take care, be well, and never forget that once you book the ticket, you will take the ride. Whatever you imagine must come to pass. Happy manifesting, guys.